Just why is football so vital to the public welfare?
Because every red-blooded young man in any country is filled with what we might call the natural spirit of combat. In many parts of Europe and elsewhere in the world, this spirit manifests itself in continuous wars and revolutions. We have tried to make competitive sport serve as a safer outlet for the spirit of combat. I believe we've succeeded.
In my day, we used the strategy of a popular sport called football to explain combat strategy. In any combat situation, you want to split their offensive line and get to the brains of the operation. In football, the quarterback is the brains of the operation. If you get him while he's still carrying the ball, your strategy works. Now, one way of doing this is by red dogging.
Andrews Tower to Washington Control. Our scope shows Red Dog 1 is right in the middle of the unknowns.
Red Dog 1 to Washington Control. Can't see anything. Wait a minute. Yeah, I see them. They're all around me.
When you're up against superior numbers, you want to sack the quarterback. You do this by red-dogging your linebacker. What this means is punching a hole through their offensive line so that your top defensive back can go right through and bring the quarterback down.
In your opinion, Mr. Rockne, what is a college for? Where do these elaborate spectacles of sport fit into the scheme of education? How would you grade an average athlete's contribution to the national intelligence?
To limit a college education to books, classrooms, or laboratories is to give to education too narrow a meaning for modern times. We believe that the finest work of man is building the character of man. We've tried to build courage, initiative, and tolerance and persistence, without which the most educated brain of man is not worth very much. Now, our boys at Notre Dame have played all over the country, and they've gotten to learn that Southerners aren't lazy, Northerners aren't cold, and Middle Westerners aren't hicks, and Californians aren't big and dumb. They've learned from all sorts of Americans what America is. And in that process, they found themselves. Now, I don't know how you'd grade a boy for learning these things, Professor. 50, 75, 90, perhaps. But wouldn't it be a good idea not to grade anybody's contribution to the national intelligence until all the results are in, maybe 5 or 10 years after graduation? When his record and character are not hung on the wall like a diploma, but inside the man himself. Say, played a great game. All of you. Great game. I guess we just can't expect to win them all. I'm going to tell you something I've kept to myself for years. None of you ever knew George Gipp. It was long before your time. But you all know what a tradition he is at Notre Dame. And the last thing he said to me, Rock, he said, sometime when the team is up against it and the brakes are beating the boys, tell them to go out there with all they got and win just one for the Gipper. I don't know where I'll be then, Rock, he said. But I'll know about it. And I'll be happy.